Hey, what's going on, everybody? Red Rhino Music here, bringing you another video. Today we are on a new game to my channel, but not a new game in general. We're on BeamNG Drive. This game's popular for its physics, because that's kind of what it's about. It's a physics sandbox driving game type thing. I don't know how to describe it. I don't know all the little names for these types of things. But to me, I would call it a physics sandbox focused on driving and cars and stuff. The reason I decided to pick it up, I only bought it the other day because it was on sale, and I've been wanting it for a while, and I never bought it for some reason. But the reason I finally picked it up is because it has a bunch of mods, and we're not really going to get into the mods for today because I just want to like introduce the game to the channel and all that, keep things kind of simple. What we're going to do is some scenarios. And I'd be down to check out any of this other stuff as far as campaigns, free roam, time trials, bus routes. This is like some Tron-looking thing, but I've never tried it. Or we could build a track, maybe. Yeah, so let me know if you guys want to see any of this stuff by hitting that like button down below, because you already know how it goes. Alright, so we're going to do some scenarios, and I don't really know what to do yet. I don't know which one I'm going to pick, but we have a bunch of them. Got a whole list of them. We could also download more. The most popular ones I've seen people do are these off-roading ones and these chase ones, because it's like a police chase or something like that. Here's another off-roading one. Here's a couple off-roading ones. A tanker delivery. Maybe we'll check that out, but that's kind of like American Truck Simulator and all that, so I don't know. Ones that sound interesting to me are hypermiling, where you just kind of have to make it to a destination with a limited amount of fuel. Like, you have just like a little bit left in the tank, and you got to make it all the way. Moose test. I think we're gonna pick Moose Test, just because I want to see what that is. Classic Emergency Lane Change Test. Oh, I'm reading it weird. Just a quick lane change. Let's check it out. But like I said, this game is known for its physics, so it's pretty realistic as far as it goes. I like the driving controls in general. That's probably my favorite thing about this game, because it's nice. You could simulate more clutch physics into the game than would be in other games. So it's a little more realistic as far as shifting and stuff. The body roll and stuff like that, everything's vehicle dependent. So like trucks will handle different than this car would or whatever. They have like little hatchbacks and stuff. Those handle different. Front wheel drive handles different than rear and all wheel drive and all that. And it's cool. You'll see it. I'll try to demonstrate some of it at least. Alright, so Moose Test. This test showcases vehicle stability in an emergency lane change. Start the lane change at 75 kilometers per hour and don't use the brakes during the maneuver. Don't hit any of the walls, which means we're probably going to hit some walls. Steer right immediately after reaching the first checkpoint to get the car turned in. Don't steer too far right or you'll delay the left turn that follows. That's kind of dramatic. So we do have different cameras, too. I'm not really worried about time right now. I'm just kind of demonstrating. Alright, so this car's automatic, and that's a good way to explain it, too. We already failed. I'm trying to explain, dude. Alright, so I'm going to explain it before I click anything. Apparently, the lowest metal we could get is wood. First gear on the stick shift. I have the Thrustmaster TH8A, so it's a 7-speed. First gear's drive. I mean, first gear's park. Neutral's neutral, second gear is drive, and then reverse is reverse. And then cars that have a selectable gearing thing you use your paddles for. And I love that idea. Like, that's just a smart use of it, because you're still shifting with a stick like you would in most cars, but it does a way of doing automatic rather than just forcing everything to be manual. Alright, let's retry this. Apparently we have a time limit. Start, turn off our parking brake, put it in drive. I didn't hit 75 kilometers? What the hell is 75 kilometers? I thought that was like 60. Send it. There you go. We got in an accident. So that's just the damage physics. It's not really gonna show us like crazy stuff going on. Like if I do a free roam or something, you kind of see how the damage happens, but try this camera, maybe I can see a little better. I damaged the car, I think we tail slapped it. Little divider thing there. We almost got it. We made it. I think I didn't have to hit the... I think I had to actually stop before I hit that wall, too. And I believe that's a gold medal. I don't know what the 0 out of 0 is, but I believe the 1 and the gold color is gold. So we're gonna hit up another scenario. That was just kind of to explain the crashing stuff. What's another one where we could explain some crashing pretty well? At least one that looks like it. The intersection ones are actually hard. I kind of tried to do one of those, and you really have to time the accident to have it work. Because the goal is to crash, not to survive. Actually, we'll do the bank robbery. This is very hard, so we're going to crash a lot, probably. Also, if any of you guys know of any mods for this game that I should check out, let me know. Let me know what they're called. It's a little hard to get mods for this game through the in-game thing, because some reason, I'm sure it has to do with my monitor being 4K, because games don't like 4K. But every time I go through like a couple pages of them, the text just stops showing up, so I just have to look at the picture and know what it is. Somebody robbed a bank and took off in an orange ETK wagon. You're the law around here, so don't let the suspects get away. Take them off the road, but don't trash my car. Okay. I'll try my best. Oh, here he is. Pull over, sicko! Of course, our car is front-wheel drive, so I can't really, like, power slide it out. I think this is the same car we're just in. Wonder if I could switch cars. Doubt it. This guy's a good driver. He's fast, too. Though we did take a lot of damage already, just hitting him. We're trying to catch him here. We're dead. I tried to brake and I locked it up too hard. Alright, let's retry this. Start. I wish I could turn off the sirens. They're kind of annoying to listen to after a while. Gotta switch up my camera after we get out in the street here. There we go. He's switching it up. I think he turned in there before. He's got a different path. That thing is so fast. Oh, he's already crashing himself. He just tapped that wall. Oh, little liftoff oversteer there. Saved it. I think we've got to stop him pretty quick. Just so fast. Oh my god, that was a giant ditch. Alright, let's try it one more time. Did say it's very hard. And it is like a weird experience with this game, because the physics are way more important than any other game. It was like that ditch or something like that. That could break the car, just hitting that. You could bust your tires out on potholes and stuff. It's pretty crazy. Course. It's tricky with the guy changing his route, too. All He's got way more power than us. I do like that he picks random roads, though. It makes it way more interesting. What is that? He's got nitrous, dog. That thing just took off. Let's not drop a wheel in that ditch. Almost did. Just can't block that thing. We overshot it a little bit. And it just broke our front bumper off. I can see why they said this is hard. Just gotta pin him. He crashed himself. What a klutz. Alright, let's get off of this screen because it's all slow motion and loud. Well, we finally did that. So, I think for scenarios, we're gonna see what else we got. If not, maybe I'll just, do some free roam. You know, let's do the electric hypermiling. That was a loud mission, let's do a real quiet one. It says difficulty's hard, or in Italy, apparently. And we just have to make it before we run out of our charge. We have to make it to a charge port. Did you know you could drive and fire a cannon? See, that's what I'm talking about. This game has so much crazy stuff. I haven't even had the opportunity to dive into everything, or, like, I haven't built anything, done any of that. I haven't tuned a car, or modded a car, or anything. I've only messed around with the base game, and most of it was just free roam. So there's so much stuff we could get into. We could just do some crazy stuff, I guess, and shoot a car with a cannon or something. We'll have to check that out in the future. Your battery's low. Can you make it to the charge point? Yeah, we'll see what we could do. Switch up cameras. Interior on this thing is pretty cool. Oh, this is nice and quiet. Which way do we gotta go? Down the hill. It's the only thing, it's a little hard to see stuff. Now, I can't really ride the clutch or anything because the car doesn't have a clutch. I just have to let it roll down the hill without crashing into something. This looks like a nice little map. Every time it goes to that cinematic camera, I freak out because I have to try to get out of it as soon as possible because I can't drive with that. Let's see if it rolls. Can we get it to roll? No, it looks like it's going to stop. Give it a little juice there. Needs a little more juice. Now we're gonna catch some speed down this hill. Some of these turns get tight because we're out here in Italy and the roads are small and stuff. They switch up real fast. Kind of what I drive like here. We have a bunch of hills. Not this crazy, but a bunch of hills where you just don't use the gas and you just ride the brake, kind of. Gonna give it some more gas to get us over that thing, and now we should be good to roll down this. I guess we're kind of looking for a mix of time, but also just making it. Do have like a little smidgen of battery there on that gas meter on the, or I guess battery meter on the bottom right there on our gauge. Stop signs don't apply to electric cars, everybody knows that. Things are going uphill now. This is where it's going to get difficult. Now the question is, do I just give it a little touch, or do I punch it and get as much speed as possible? Okay, well, we're not going to punch it here. This would... we would have just went straight into the guardrail. This thing drives pretty nice. About halfway done, just a little past halfway. Alright, well now this is gonna get weird because we're in a town, so it's gonna be hard to see the checkpoints. I think we're gonna switch our camera a little bit like that, just so we can look in the air. It's a fueling station there, but we don't drive with gas, we drive with battery. Looks like we take a right, yes. Feel like I'm in a Grand Tour episode. Okay, got this little left-hander here. Two more spots. How do people drive in these places? Alright, here we are. That wasn't that hard. 420. We got a gold medal. There we go. Alright guys, that's been BeamNG. I just wanted to take a quick look at it, introduce it to the channel, and see what you guys think. If you guys want to see more of this on the channel, make sure you hit that like button down below. And any of the stuff that I went through, any of these scenarios or anything, let me know if you want to see any of them. I don't know what the campaigns are. I haven't checked those out. I've done the bus routes thing a little bit, and those are kind of fun. So maybe we'll do some of that. I still got to check out a lot of this game on my own, too, just to see what stuff is. We have all these free-roaming maps. We could download more. We could build our own map if we want. Time trials, bus routes, light runner. It's kind of like this Tron-looking thing, but I don't really know what it is. Anyways, that's it for this one. Thanks for watching. See y'all next time. Peace.